Okay. I'm Father David Greenfield. I'm from All Saints Catholic Church here in Berlin. And helping me today is Sister Michaeline. And we're happy to be able to assist you today. And I'm glad that it worked out this way that we could do this. I want to thank this family and compliment you for making the effort to do what we and what the church feels is appropriate. You know, your nieces and nephews, I don't want to say only nieces, but there's no close family left. And sometimes we see, you know, things just kind of drift away and families wouldn't go through this effort. And that's kind of sad, but it's wonderful to see you do this. And we give a proper Christian, respectful burial to everyone, at least we try to, because we are all children of God. So thank you for being here. Let us begin in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
In the few moments that lie ahead, we will pray church liturgy, which throughout the life of the church has been prayed literally thousands and thousands of times. Yet they are no less reliable and no less true today than when they were uttered for the first time. And that's because God's promises never change, and God never changes, ever. In the waters of baptism, Louise died with Christ and rose with him to new life. May she now share with him eternal glory. Let us pray. O God, to whom mercy and forgiveness belong, hear our prayers on behalf of your servant Louise, whom you have called out of this world. And because she put her hope and trust in you, command that she be carried safely home to heaven and may come to enjoy your eternal rewards. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
Amen. Sister will lead us now in the first reading. You may remain seated.
A reading from the book of Job. Then Job answered and said, "Oh, would that my words were written down. Would that they were inscribed in a record, that with an iron chisel and with lead, they were engraved in a rock forever. As for me, I know my Redeemer lives, and that he will at last stand forth upon the earth. I will see for myself, my own eyes, not another's, will behold him. And from my flesh, I will see God. My innermost being is consumed with longing." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Would you please stand for the reading of the Holy Gospel? The Lord be with you.
And with with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory
to you, O Lord. Jesus told his disciples, "Do not let your hearts be troubled. You have faith in God. Have faith also in me. In my Father's house there are many dwelling places. If there were not, would I have told you that I am going to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come back again and take you to myself, so that where I am, you also may be. Where I am going, you know the way." Thomas said to him, "Master, we do not know where you are going. How can we know the way?" Jesus said to him, "I am the way, and the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
You may be seated, please. To the relatives of Louise Schmuhl, and to any friends and relatives who are here, on behalf of All Saints Catholic Church, we give you our Christian sympathy. Louise was born into this world on February 27th, 1926. And in 1952, she was united in marriage to John Schmuhl at Our Lady of the Lake Parish in Green Lake. Louise was finally born into eternity on June 11th, 2020. So 94 years, right? 94 years. Imagine the changes that she saw during that time. I'm sure there's one thing we can probably be sure of, especially to our young people here, and that is that that Louise and her husband didn't meet through an online dating service. The end of life comes at different times for everyone, doesn't it? But Scripture tells us that actually we are created to be eternal. This life, this mortal life, comes to an end, yes. But there is more. And our souls live on. We are created to be eternal. You know, I really believe that if people are honest with themselves, that, and sometimes we don't want to be, but I believe that if people are honest with themselves, they instinctively know, deep down inside, that there's more to our existence and more to our purpose than this. We are created to be eternal, and God's desire is that ultimately our purpose is to once again be with Him. And the Church refers to that instinctive knowledge as natural law. That is to say, certain things, certain truths that are imprinted on our hearts and our minds by the Creator. The Gospel we read, the setting it takes place after Christ's resurrection, and Jesus is telling his disciples that he must now leave them to go back to his Father. And he says to them, "In my Father's house are many dwelling places," or some translations will say, "many rooms." In my Father's house is much, much room. "And I go to prepare a place for you. And where I am going, you know the way." And then Thomas is one of his disciples, always kind of questioned things. And he says, Lord, we don't know where you are going. How can we know the way? And every time I read that gospel, I realize that there are still people today who feel that way. Maybe some of us do sometimes. What's the right way? You know, if you ever feel that way, you are not alone. It's nothing new. This gospel was written almost 2,000 years ago, and Thomas said it then. And you can almost hear the frustration in his voice as he says, Lord, we don't know where you are going. How can we know the way? And then Jesus says those powerful words. He says, Thomas, I am the way. I am the way and the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. And then he goes on to promise, in my Father's house are many rooms, and I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go to prepare a place for you, I will come back again and take you to myself. You know, Jesus, it's like Jesus is saying, think through this. You know, it only makes sense, right? That if I go to prepare a place for you, then something's going to follow. I will come back and take you to myself. On June 11th, 2020, Louise's room was ready, and God called her home. It's important that we be ready as well, so one day we can join her and so many others who have gone before us. Our prayers are with all of you, and Louise and this burial will be mentioned in our intercessions at church, at Mass, because she's being buried by the church. And again, thank you for taking this time and effort to show respect and love for Louise, who we trust now is with her husband and many others in the presence of the Lord. We're going to have a song now that I understand she requested, and it'll be a quiet time of reflection.
Consider all the words I can tell.
Would you please stand for the intercessions, and Sister will lead us in those as well.
For Louise, when baptism was given the pledge of eternal life, may she now be admitted to the company of saints. We pray to the Lord.
Lord,
have mercy. For our sister Louise, who consumed the true body of Christ, the bread of life, may she be raised up on that last day. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For Louise's family, relatives, and friends, and all who helped her along this earthly path, may they be rewarded for their goodness. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For Louise, along with her husband John, daughters Marilyn and Sally, and other loved ones who have gone before her, together may they see God face to face. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For all of us assembled here to pray and worship, may we be faithful to Christ and his church so we too can at last be gathered together in God's kingdom. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Father in heaven, we trust in your promises and we rely on your mercy. Hear these prayers offered to you in the name of Christ your Son, who lives and reigns with you forever and ever.
Amen.
Amen. You may remain standing, please. Before we go our separate ways, let us take leave of our sister Louise. May our farewell express our affection for her. May it ease our sadness and strengthen our hope. One day we shall joyfully greet her again when the love of Christ, which conquers all things, will destroy even death itself. We should think about that for a moment. There's some irony there, right? Even death will die, and it will be no more. And there will be no more cause for us to get together like this. We'll still get together, but not for this. That's God's promise. Into your hands, Father of mercies, we commend our sister Louise in the sure and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, she will rise with him on the last day. We give you thanks for the blessings which you bestowed upon Louise in this life. They are signs to us of your goodness and of our fellowship with the saints in Christ. And I want to address some of those blessings. I'm sorry I didn't have those names as ready as I thought I did, but I hope that I have these correct. You know, here, when this prayer talks about blessings, it's not talking about bank accounts or land or what have you. It's talking about you. Blessings, the real blessings in life. Her daughter Beverly and husband Doug. Her seven grandchildren, Stephen, Michelle, Anne Marie, Preston, Angela, Heather, and Luke. And several great grandchildren. And a brother, a remaining brother, Neil. And all of her relatives and friends. They are signs to us of your goodness and of our fellowship in Christ. Merciful Lord, turn toward us and listen to our prayers. Open wide the gates of paradise to your servant and help us who remain to comfort one another with words of faith, until we all meet in Christ and are with you and with our sister forever. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Amen. Saints of God, come to her aid. Hasten to meet her, angels of the Lord. Receive her soul and present her to God the Most High. The Christian believes that when we make this journey, we don't make it alone. There's a lot of unanswered questions, aren't there? Lots of questions about the next life. But I am convinced we don't make it alone. When we let go of someone on this side, at that same time, in that same hour, there are other hands on the other side reaching out to her and voices calling to her to guide her home. Saints of God, come to her aid. Come and meet her. Hurry and meet her, angels of the Lord. Receive her soul and present her to God the Most High. Louise, may the angels lead you into paradise. May the martyrs come to welcome you and take you to the holy city, the new and eternal Jerusalem. Please bow your heads for a final blessing. God, our shelter and our strength, you hear in love the cry of your people. Hear the prayers we have offered today for our departed sister. Cleanse her and us of all of our sins and grant us the fullness of redemption. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen. May Almighty God bless you and be with you. Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen. May go in peace. Thanks be to God.